sure about that? You want me to go, why not come back? You want me to leave my love behind? I have one for you. Devil's going to make me crazy.
One of the unexpected advantages of getting a 90s car and fitting it with its original CD player is rediscovering your CDs. So I've found my box of CDs in the Wendy house, and I must say, yeah, I'm enjoying discovering all the music from my youth again. So it's been a while since I've given you an update on my Subaru SVX. In fact, I bought it in December last year. It is pretty much going on to a year by now. And immediately took it to a Subaru expert where I left it for 3 months. And I gave him a long list of things to sort out. And happily, most of the things on that list was sorted out. Not everything though, and I mean it is a work in progress, but I have an air conditioning climate control system that actually works. His brother managed to get the digital displays of the climate control system working again. I regassed it and it works. Cruise control works. The sunroof even works again. What else? As I said, I retrofitted the original radio from the car, found it. The previous owner kindly sent it to me from Germany, and we fitted it with new speakers behind the original sort of cover, so it doesn't look aftermarket. Sounds great. And since then the car's been running reliably. No major issues to report on. I've managed to make most of the dashboard that was very faded black again. I think that was... No, it's called black back, or back black. Anyway, some sort of a treatment to the dashboard to make it look neat and black again. There are some challenges remaining. So the steering column is supposed to adjust up and down, and it adjusts, but it doesn't lock into position. And I've discovered that in the original car magazine test of January 1994, which was on this specific car, they mentioned in that test that the steering column adjustment failed. So it has, since 1994, it has not been fixed. And the guy who had the car for 3 months said it would need either a new part, which pretty much impossible to get, or some pretty serious machining. So I'm still driving with the steering wheel between my legs, like in a modern day Peugeot, except that I can't see my instruments at all. The other problem that persists is the sun visor floppy syndrome. So there's the Velcro, it's very strong Velcro, and this side it actually works okay because it's not as floppy as on this side. I mean, I've basically given up. Otherwise, nothing much to report. The suede, I don't know what to do with the suede, it's quite rough in some areas. Then I need to get the leather redone. The car stood in the sun for a long time, so the leather is in really bad shape, cracked and torn in some places. And then there's wood trim, man. I think what I'm going to do with the wood trim, my colleague Dwayne Asplings had a brilliant idea. I'm going to remove the wood trim, fix it as much as we can, and then hydro dip it with some sort of a wood finish that's similar to what it has now. And then I think, you know, the car is pretty presentable. I think on the outside, I'll show you later, is already very presentable, because I took it to finally have the roof painted, have the bumper cracks fixed, the bumpers repainted, a couple of dings taken out. Okay, so as you can see, she presents very well. The front bumper, this was completely cracked. It's been completely repainted, and the color matching by the guys who did it was actually very good. I must say, I didn't expect, because this is quite a difficult pearl white to fix. A couple of dents on the bonnet also removed. Then the roof. Just look at this. Beautiful and shiny roof. No more fading. Couple of loose rubbers still remaining, like this. Sunroof works. This rubber is completely new, imported out of Japan. And at the back, yeah, not much had to be done. Just did a little bit of touch-up paint on the bumper. That's pretty cool. So if you know nothing about the Subaru SVX, which is the case for most people in this country, it was quite a statement car for Subaru in the early 90s, because up to that point, you know, people really associated Subaru with, like, you know, pretty rough road, rough terrain station wagon, four-wheel drive station wagons and so on. So this was quite a, you know, shot out of nowhere, to be honest. It had, at the time, Subaru's biggest boxer engine yet, the 3.3 liter flat six, and all-wheel drive, obviously. And then they gave the styling to Giugiaro, and Giugiaro came up with this beautiful concept, and I don't think anybody expected Subaru to build it, and they basically just said, yes, that print, done. So when the car was launched, I mean, it looked like a spaceship, and people still look at the car like it's, you know, from the future. So what's the performance like? You know, at the time, this was the biggest and most powerful engine that Subaru had ever done. It's a 3.3 liter flat six boxer, 169 kilowatt and 309 newton meters of torque, which, you know, isn't really that much. It's quite a pretty, it's a decently heavy car as well, all-wheel drive. And the only gearbox they had at the time that could handle the torque was a four-speed auto. And so it's more of a, like, a relaxed but pretty fast GT. Top speed is 226 k's per hour, and you can accelerate to 100 just under 10 seconds, like 9.75. So it's not like a sports car, it's a GT. It does, however, handle exceptionally well. Very low center of gravity, wide, low car. Obviously the boxer engine brings the center of gravity down as well, so it corners really nicely, actually pretty neutral as well. Okay, let's see what she can do. Drive mode, it's not in economy mode. Yeah, quite a nice raspy sound. Oh, there goes all my CDs. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Even caught up with a Porsche. Yeah, I think new brakes, new shocks, probably next. And we're done. thanks so much for watching, guys. If you do own a Subaru SVX, or if you know of somebody who owns a Subaru SVX in South Africa, please be so kind to point them my way, and maybe we can get in touch and, I don't know, share parts. It's a really small community of owners on this car, so every little bit helps. Thank you. Bye-bye.